Yes, we have seen how the curd converted into milk by the fission of bacteria. One more mode of asexual reproduction is fission. Here, sir, what do you mean by fission? Here, fission is two type: binary fission and multiple fission. As you know that the body is divided into two equal parts by asexual reproduction is called binary fission. How you know very well in the amoeba is the unicellular organisms. Amoeba by the binary fission it reproduces. You know very well amoeba is unicellular organism. Unicellular organism in the sense the organisms which made by only one cell, here only one cell can perform all the functions like respiration, digestion, excretion. All these functions are done by only one cell. Here amoeba is shapeless organism, it is only one cell. Here sir, how the amoeba reproduce? Here the adult amoeba, first the nucleus is going to split into two. Here the division is taking place in the nucleus, and later there is a division in the middle of the body, means the permeable membrane is constrict and move towards the center of the body. This is the nucleus, and then the nucleus is separated, and as well as the permeable membrane also separated. Then these two are individuals, they can survive individually. It is the binary fission. By the binary means, by means two. By the binary fission, the amoeba is reproduces to produce offsprings, and sometimes the nucleus will be splitting into three or four, more than two. It is multiple fission. The four babies becomes here. It is the multiple fission. And the paramecium reproduces depend upon the temperature conditions and the favorable conditions. Here in the favorable conditions, the amoeba, the paramecium by the fission in the same way, by the fission in these favorable conditions, the paramecium becomes two babies. And unfavorable conditions, in the unfavorable conditions, the paramecium reproduce by conjugation. Conjugation is nothing but the, it is mode of the sexual reproduction. Means the two paramecium come in contact together and they share the genetic material. Share the genetic material and then they reproduce the babies in this way. Here favorable conditions, in the favorable conditions the paramecium is reproduces through the fission, and unfavorable conditions the paramecium reproduce the embryos of their own kind. It is called as conjugation. In this conjugation the offsprings are more tolerant than the fission. Now let us discuss about the asexual mode of reproduction in plants. Here you know very well plants also reproduce through the sexual and asexual. Here in the sexual reproduction, as I told you, pollen grains and ova, here also ova, male and female flowers are there. Bisexual, unisexual flowers are there. We know very well in the unisexual flowers, males and females are there, and in the bisexual flowers, male and female parts within the flower, and in the unisexual flowers only either that is belongs to male or female, and male parts are there in some plants, female parts are there in the other plants. Here asexual reproduction in the plants, it is nothing but the vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation. Here, by this vegetative propagation means by the vegetative parts. You know very well, flower is the sexual part of the flower, but other parts like stems, roots, and leaves, and other parts are vegetative parts. Here, first one by the leaves. By the leaves, some of the plants reproduce. Have you seen the bryophyllum? Bryophyllum, it is a thick flower which is sticky in nature, and we may see in the flower the buds are going to bear, and if these buds contact with the soil, or if we cut and keep in the soil, then this bud become a new plant. Next, stem. By the stem, you know very well, some soft stems, they climb on the ground, then where there is a node, these nodes are enters into the soil and then gets the roots. If you cut this area, then these are going to take new plants. Here, example, Valisneria and strawberry. And roots. By the roots, carrots. Carrots can reproduce through the roots. And tubers. Potato. We will discuss in detail in the further classes. Just I am giving the examples. By the leaves, biophyllum and stem, Valisneria and strawberry, and as well as roots, by the roots, the carrot will reproduce young ones, and potato by the tubers. It is natural vegetative propagation. Natural and artificial propagation, whatever I told, by stem and roots and other parts of the vegetative parts, these are naturally occurs in the nature, and artificial propagation, in the artificial propagation, cutting, layering, and grafting. These are the three methods, these are three techniques we can artificially produce the plants. For example, first one, cutting. Take a potted plant and cut your branch. That should have the bud. Bud is compulsory here. Now cut this portion which has the bud and keep this in the soil. And this, here there is no roots. This cut portion, buried in the water, in the soil, and gets the roots, and it can grow an individual plant. example rose and hibiscus. It is the cutting, it is artificial propagation. Next one, layering. Sir, what do you mean by layering? Here some plants weak branches are there. If this branch touches the soil, I mean from this area going to burrow in the soil, and they get the roots, and if you cut this area, then by this way this plant become a new plant. Example, Nerium. Next, grafting, which is very interesting topic. Now the grafting. In the grafting, we need two plants. First, for example, it is a plant. Cut some portion. It is called stalk. And select any other plant in the same species. Any other plant. Also cut this plant into half. This leave this half of the plant which is the above portion, and keep this cut portion on this area. And tie it with thread and cover with polythene cover. After few days, it becomes a new plant. Example, mango, apple, citrus family fruits. Here, it is the stalk, it is the scion. In this way, we can get high yielding and varieties of yielding. For example, here two mango plants are there, A and B. The A mango plant is the plant which has a big size mango and less number, and plant B, it has more number of fruits but size is small and there is no more taste. But plant A has big sized mango and as well as seed mango. Plant B has more number of fruits but size is small but no more taste. Then if you take plant A as stalk and plant B as scion, if you graft it like this, then this plant become a new plant and we get big size mango and taste also very good and more sweet than this B one. In this way, we get varieties of yielding and high yield. In the flowers also, we can get the different colors of the flowers by this way. Yes, let us conclude this lesson. Today we discussed about the reproduction. Reproduction means the process in which the organisms reproduce, means produce young ones of their own kind. The reproduction can be divided into sexual, asexual. In the sexual reproduction, we need gametes. Gametes in the sense sex cells. Sex cells. Here we need male and female gametes. The male and female gamete become zygote. The zygote become baby. It is the sexual reproduction. In the asexual reproduction, we need not these sperm cell and the ova. By only one parent, the plants can, and young ones also can produce young ones of their own kind. we have seen binary division in amoeba and paramecium and conjugation in paramecium, and as well as the vegetative propagation can be artificial and the natural. Artificial is grafting, layering, cutting, and natural is by the stem, by the roots, by other parts they can produce. Hope you understood the lesson. Next class we will discuss in detail. Thank you.